As much research exists on the unhealthiness of prolonged unsupervised mask wearing as there is on the benefits, we need to get all pupils back into the classroom in a positive learning environment. As for them, Cymru is an example of concerned parents who want clear direction on freedom to choose, because many pupils have been told that the wearing of masks in the classroom over a prolonged period is mandatory. And policing in all senses works best on consensus. There are real physical and mental impairments to mask wearing. And the issue of some head teachers mandating the wearing of masks is causing real anxiety, possible future health problems depending on the mask and what is done with the mask before wearing. And for many pupils, it is a barrier to learning. So what I'm looking for here is some kind of responsibility, because you've omitted to really address the issue of pupils having to wear masks in classrooms over a prolonged period. So what will you do to support parents, pupils, and staff who choose not to wear masks or who want to not wear masks in the classroom over a prolonged period? What are you going to do to support those people?
I'm not aware that we're asking children to wear masks in an unsupervised situation at all. Children are supervised on school transport, and when they're in classrooms, they are supervised. The advice that we're giving is that when social distancing cannot be maintained, then masks should be worn, because that offers a level of protection, as I said, to both staff and learners. There are times when masks are not appropriate, such as meal times, when outside and social distancing is possible, when learners are running around playing active games, and where learners do have a genuine specific barrier to wearing a mask. What I would say to parents and pupils, I'm very grateful for their continuing willingness to engage actively with us as Welsh Government and with head teachers, and recognise the steps that we can all play to minimise disruption to education and to keep them learning. And I'm very grateful for their willingness to continue to do so.
David Melding.